What is going on, everybody? I'm Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. A few weeks have passed since Apple unveiled iPadOS 14 as a developer beta, and it is the company's latest attempt to catapult the iPad into the portable computing powerhouse that we all know it is destined to become. One of the really creative ways that Apple is intending to accomplish this is by continuing to blend analog techniques from the real world into the iPad to deliver a cohesive user experience. I have spent the last several weeks dissecting the developer beta, and there are a lot of great features coming to the iPadOS this fall, but really nothing has me excited for iPadOS to come out as Scribble. And in today's video, I'm going to tell you all about Scribble and why it's going to be a game-changing feature that's going to redefine your iPad experience. Let's get started. The fundamental technology behind Scribble is nothing new or groundbreaking. As a matter of fact, the core technology has existed since the early part of the 20th century, and if I really want to date myself here, I remember using a very primitive version of handwriting recognition called graffiti, wait for it, in a Palm Pilot. Now, if you don't know what Palm Pilot is, let me know in the comments below, but this is really one of the founding members of the modern smartphone. Much like all things Apple, really the secret sauce is going to be in how the technology is implemented. As I said in the beginning of the video, Apple has a plethora of great features coming out this fall in iOS 14 as well as iPadOS 14, and I have a number of other videos that preview each of the new features as well as the full review of iOS and iPadOS 14. So if you like what you've seen thus far and you want to go ahead and get more videos just like it, make sure you click subscribe and turn on notifications so you can be alerted when that new content drops. I would describe Scribble as a technology that has three core features that are bundled together in order to create a cohesive iPad experience. At its core, the automatic conversion of handwriting into typed text is really what makes Scribble possible. You're going to use your Apple Pencil, you're going to write in any text field, and the system will automatically convert any of your handwritten text into typed text that's readable by the system. It's kind of amazing because this conversion works with a number of different handwriting styles. You know, it doesn't have to be my handwriting styles. Your handwriting does not need to be perfect, nor is it limited to be only using, you know, cursive or print handwriting. Now there's zero setup required, meaning that I don't need to write out the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog to establish any type of training. Now I pick up the pencil to write and the system converts it out into system readable text. Now the analysis conversion happens, you know, very quickly and by no means is it slow or laggy. And I think it's reasonable to assume that the speed will only get better as the beta progresses throughout the summer because Apple's really driving this feature hard as one of the core tenets in iPadOS 14. Strangely enough, I've seen better success rates when using cursive handwriting opposed to print, but that doesn't seem to be like some type of limitation. Let me know what your experiences are in the comments below if you're running iPadOS 14. For me, I would estimate the accuracy rate being somewhere in the low to mid 90s. Accuracy rate notwithstanding, you can simply scratch out any text that you want to go ahead and delete if a mistake is made. What's great here is that you can handwrite in any app, even though iPadOS 14 is still in beta for the next few months. That's because Apple was really pushing iPad developers hard if you had an app to support Pencil Kit. You know, they knew this was coming. And now that the ability to convert handwriting into system readable text is part of Pencil Kit, if you run iPadOS 14, all of the apps, including Apple's own first party apps like Mail, Map, Messages, and almost all the third party apps I have on my iPad are working with this on day one of the beta. Now that includes my Reddit app of choice, which is going to be Apollo, my email app of choice, which is going to be Spark Email, and even Twitter. That's not to say the support is perfect, but I think it's possible that many developers can update their apps with iPadOS 14 to take advantage of Scribble without a significant amount of rework. Now, most importantly, the handwriting conversion is going to stay private. All the machine learning that is used to analyze and convert your handwriting is performed on device, and it's not sent to or stored in the cloud. Other than the initial download of the language model that's going to be used with Scribble, you do not need to have an internet connection. The second component of Scribble is going to be shape recognition. Now, this is going to take geometric shapes that you draw by freehand and turn them into symmetrical bliss so it doesn't resemble something that is coming from a three-year-old. This feature is going to work with circles, stars, squares, hearts, triangles, ovals, diamonds, speech bubbles, curved lines, and arrows. Now, for me, this makes drawing so much easier, especially in the Notes app when you say you want to draw a diagram for a new studio that you're moving into very soon. Much, much easier. And the last component of Scribble are expanded data detectors. Now, data detectors enable the iPad to go ahead and automatically recognize telephone numbers, physical addresses, email addresses, calendar entries in handwritten text to take action on it. So what that means is you can write down a phone number, say, call Mike on your iPad, and that's going to be 312-555-1212. And later on, you can pull that note up on your iPad, take action on it. That is pretty freaking cool. Since Scribble will work on any iPad that supports the Apple Pencil, Apple Pencil 2, when the system language is English, simplified Chinese, or traditional Chinese, and the fact that you can not only search handwritten text on your iPad, but also from your iPhone and take action on it as well, I think this is going to be huge based on two factors. First, the addition of Scribble is extremely enjoyable for iPad users because they no longer need to approach using the iPad with this very narrow this or that dichotomy of regarding the Apple Pencil or the Magic Keyboard. It enables a user to choose whether they want to use the Apple Pencil or the Magic Keyboard based on what is the best tool for the job and the level of effort required to complete the task. I can remove my iPad from the Magic Keyboard while continuing to be productive with only my Apple Pencil as the input device. This allows me to remain in context without the need to move back and forth between the Magic Keyboard and the Apple Pencil. We all know that remaining in context for as long as possible is what's going to drive increases in productivity. You can think of the Apple Pencil as abstracting some of the jobs to be done from the Magic Keyboard in order to compartmentalize smaller tasks that will be used with the Apple Pencil. Now, this is not to say that the Apple Pencil will replace the Magic Keyboard for myself or anyone else really watching this video, because no one wants to literally write a long email with their Apple Pencil. Second, Scribble is going to change the way that you interact with your iPad today, and I think it paves the way for the technology to come to the iPhone sooner rather than later. Since all of your handwriting is indexed by the operating system and searchable within the application on either platform, and it's completely reasonable to think that this is going to make its way to the iPhone. Now, it plays directly into the rumors that we've been hearing about that the iPhone coming in a larger size screen and that it would some level support an input device that was similar to an Apple Pencil. And not to be too cynical here, but this is a really convenient way for Apple to increase the average revenue per user by selling what arguably is one of the best accessories for the iPad to millions of iPhone customers. This wraps up my preview of Scribble for iPadOS 14. If you are running an iPadOS 14 beta, let me know in the comments below how Scribble is working for you. Again, there's more content planned for iOS 14 and iPadOS 14, including a full review of each operating system when they are released in the fall. So make sure you're subscribed with notifications so you can be alerted when that content drops. You don't want to miss this. I am Mike. This is Tech 24/7 TV, and I'll catch you in the next one.